There's a treasure trove of information on 401k plans at the U.S. Department of Labor, but sifting through the data is not easy, which is exactly why BrightScope and ICI team up to do it. Here are the latest insights from their report.
So in this report, we're able to look at thousands of large 401k plans to get insight into what 401k plan design looks like.
So what do you see in the data?
We find that 9 out of 10 401k participants are in plans that have employer contributions. Now, the most common way to do that for the employer is through a matching contribution. So a very important incentive for workers to get that added, you know, support from the employer.
And you're also able to look at this data and analyze the investment menu?
Yes, so when we look at the investment options offered in 401k plans, we find that on average there are more than 20 options in a given plan, and these really cover a range of risk and return. Nearly all plans offer domestic equity funds, international equity funds, and domestic bond funds, although the average number of funds offered varies, with 10 domestic equity funds on average, 3 international equity funds on average, and 3 domestic bond funds on average. We also are able to analyze the role of index funds in these plans, and we see that 9 out of 10 large 401k plans include index funds in their lineup.
And finally, you take a look at the fee data.
We see that larger plans, having a bigger base of assets, typically have lower fees when you measure them as a percentage of assets because they've got a bigger base to spread the fixed cost over compared to smaller plans. But we see in this research something we find in our own work when we look at mutual fund investors as a whole from the 401k space, this, you know, tendency to concentrate their assets in lower cost funds.